Give me Senator Bobby Kennedy, please.
Senator Bobby Kennedy. Surely, Mr. President.
Hello?
Senator Robert Kennedy, 9-0.
Bobby, how are you?
Fine, thanks, Mr. President. How are you?
Pretty good. I'm going to have a little operation Friday morning for a gallbladder condition that I'll announce in a little bit. And I was calling you on another matter, but I thought I might tell you before you heard it on the radio.
Oh, I see. But it's not serious, is it?
I don't think so. There's a pretty big gallbladder club, but no one ever knows until I get it behind them. It hasn't given me any trouble, but they think it might... rupture or something. If I get it taken care of, got a lot of stones in it.
Well, take care of yourself, Mr. President.
Bobby, I'm going to, I want to send the name of Jim Watson, who's now on the court up in New York, to the Senate for a vacancy we have for Negro on the Customs Court. It's been vacant for some time. One of Truman's appointees, I believe, retired.
Yeah.
And I'm going to send a judge, a Republican judge from Indiana. Got a FBI back on Watson. He's on some state court and I want to promote him. It'll be a vacancy, but as I understand it, it'll be filled by appointment temporarily.
Yeah.
Do you know him?
Jim, is his name Jim Watson?
Yeah.
No, I don't know him.
I met him. President Kennedy asked me to take him to Jamaica to the Independence Day ceremony.
Yeah.
And I took him and met him and have known him since then. He was a good supporter of ours in 60.
That's fine.
Was in the state legislature in New York. Then he was elected a judge in New York.
Yeah.
And the judgeship pays 25. This customs court sits in New York. And it's had two vacancies, and it's a lifetime job. The state judgeship is a 10-year job.
Yeah.
But I didn't want to send him up until I talked to you. And,
that's fine. You know, whatever you say.
Thank you, my friend.
Mr. President,
yeah.
You know, I talked to Bill Moyers about the Papal Nuncio.
Yes, I asked Russ to see him. I'm going to the hospital Thursday. I talked to the Pope about him yesterday. We are very distressed about what's happened there, and we've got Bunker there every moment. I called him up over this weekend. The Fulbright thing nearly destroyed us. I don't think we've hardly won an election because our own people have questioned what we've done.
Yeah.
And there's a good deal of anti-American sentiment. I'm confident that we'd have had another Castro if we hadn't have gone in when we did. But the two or three stories, Schutz's coverage and one or two others have put us in a rather bad light. And our own folks' statements are being used very effectively against us, and there's a good deal of anti-American sentiment, as you know, has been there all through the years. And I don't know, Bunker thinks that this fellow in another week or 10 days may be able to get the leftish disarmed and Camano's group integrated back in the army, and Bunker's back down there trying to get that done. If he's unable to do it, we're going to have a choice then of either having to identify ourselves with another outfit or see the Army come back in for a takeover, and it's going to be a very difficult choice.
Yeah. Well, can I just be frank about it with you? I just think that this is not the kind of thing that, I mean, I'm glad to have Secretary Russ see him. I just don't think it's the kind of thing that he's going to understand. And, you know, this man's got some criticism about how the situation is being handled. He has some rather extreme ideas about what could be done in the future. He doesn't think that it's a question of money. And it's got to be, whoever talks to him has to have your confidence and be able to, if the idea makes any sense, put it into operation. But if it ever gets lost in the machinery of the State Department, it's never going to be done.
Well, I asked Russ this afternoon. He told me when I brought it up with Mac and group that was present that he had an appointment with the Papal Nuncio, who apparently has asked to see him. He came down for this cabinet meeting when I told him I was going to the hospital. And he said he had an appointment with him and he'd report right back, and I told him Mike Bundy to carry through with it. I know what he's going to say. He's going to say just what Bunker said this week, that things are in a hell of a mess there.
But he has some ideas, Mr. President.
All right.
Well, about what, you know, just on the question, he says there's tremendous starvation throughout the country.
There is, and they want about $30 million immediate program, and our economic people are working on it. But the question is, if we're going to turn it into a communist base, when and how we ought to handle it. We're hoping that we can get people that would handle the aid that we are ready to put in there. We think ultimately it costs maybe $100 million.
Yeah. He says that he thinks that, that with the present machinery that most of that money is going to stick to the hands of those who have it.
Well, we're afraid of that too. We've got Bunker's trying now to get us a new ambassador. We've destroyed the one we've had, which my feeling and the others that dealt with him was did a good job and was a good man for it. But he's been pretty well discredited by his own citizens back at home. And we've got to get a new man in there, and I guess under him set up the economic program. We've got Tony Solomon, who's in charge of the economic aspects of Latin America, trying to lay out the program. He fed him during the whole period before this provisional government got in. And I'm prepared, ready, and willing to put dozens of millions in there to help restore their economy and carry them at least through the next year, because the election's 9 months.
Well,
but I think the first thing we got to do is get this provisional president to get the arms back in the arsenals and get the men back in the army, which he hopes he can do this week. And if he can't do it, then we may have all hell break loose again and have our own troops under fire.
Can I give you again what he thinks?
Sure.
That his feeling is that so much of there's so much corruption there that if it's handled through a government that's established, a lot of it's going to stick to people's hands, or it's going to be used for political purposes, and that it really has to be handled, that the starvation is facing the people right at the moment. Hello?
Yes.
We're on.
Go ahead.
You're on? Good.
Yes. And that it has to be that if it's done just through the government, that it's going to be lost, and that if we could get the money, if we could get the food, and it was obvious that it came from the United States to the people right away, that it could be effective. Now, what he thinks that as long as the that if you establish something through some of the religious and private organizations down there. I asked the leading Protestant bishop and the Catholic bishop, and if there's any Jew or whatever there might be there, to undertake the distribution throughout the country, and that they and set up through their regular channels, which is overseen by some of these people and with whom everybody has confidence, and they did it, that it could be very effective, and that would be clear that it wouldn't be for religious purposes, but just to try to get the food out to the people, that it's going to take such a long period of time to do it through the government, and it's going to also, so much of it's going to be lost. That he said, he's seen 12 governments since he's been down there, and so much of it's corrupt, and that they all steal, and it's accepted.
Yes, I think that's true, and our problem now is how to get this government to keep it from turning communist, and they're getting control of it. I'll pass on to Bunker, who is down there with Tony Solomon, trying to set up an economic plan for the whole island, these suggestions, and see if they think that to see how they can work them out with them.
Well, fine. Take care of yourself.
Thank you, Bobby.